So again, let me just reiterate, this will be our final write-up, and hopefully we can have our oral defense by 16 or madala sa 13. Let us just see if makaya sa time. Double time lang jud ka. I was really hoping that probably by 13 ready na inyong paper tanan, kompleto na from preliminary pages down to appendices, so that on the 16th we can have the final oral defense na. Okay, what you're going to do is just update your PowerPoint, no? Your PowerPoint already has content naman, pero na may mga changes dito based on the corrections pag last pre-oral. Just kindly apply those corrections, and then corrections sa yung PowerPoint, no? Kay kung na-correct na ninyo ang manuscript, ato pa, no, before mo nag-survey, pero wala na-correct ang PowerPoint, i-update pa ninyo ang PowerPoint, okay? And then sumpayan lang ninyo with the results, no? The presentation of the results. So, again, no, you are writing right now 3 to 4. We are hoping by 13 or earlier than 13, you are done na already, complete na with preliminaries and appendices pages, so that by 16, we are now good to go. Okay? So, let's begin. Let us start first with the preliminary pages, no? Because you're going to have a write-up rejapon dire. Okay. So, this is an example of a preliminary page. Preliminary pages, di I know. You already have the title page and the table of contents. Ato lang kulang isang abstract, acknowledgement, and update of your table of contents, as well as your approval sheet. Now, your approval sheet will be, kuan na siya, kanang, what do you call this? Okay, ang approval sheet ninyo, ready-made na siya daan. I will just change the name of the panelist, no? Mapunin siya ang kind of setback nung ano, lain-lain na itong panelist. So, siguro I will just write down the names. Kasi supposedly, I don't know how this year is so informal, because kung kinsara available nga panelist ang musit, you know, I'm used to having the same set of panelists pag pre-oral or final. Hopefully, the same rejapon. Kaya ang natabo sa inyo nga case, kung kinsara available, and I have no control over that since, again, no, muna may ninasugdan, di, muna lang gipadayon po. So, anyway, I will just change this to the name of your other teacher. Siguro I'll just put Sir Service po and Sir Verson here, since sila man po nang kauban ako sa uban po nga strand, so that sila lang dyan atong i-fix as panel. Okay? So, here is the approval sheet. This is the only thing that will be fixed na. No? Igon lang ninyo is ang title na lang o ang inyuhang names. And then, I will be the one who will provide this, because dapat same og format ang tanan. Okay, and then I will just, oh yeah, hindi rin ako i-change name. I'll just change the name of the school principal siguro as well. Tang-tangon lang ako ni. Then, school principal. Anyway, the contents of this, you already have the title page, approval sheet, fixed na ni siya. And then, we have the acknowledgement. After acknowledgement, you will have the abstract. We will discuss that one by one later. So, we'll just have a run-through. Okay, and then we have the abstract. Usually, we will require at least 250 to 500 pages, but it's up to you how to summarize it. This is very vital, especially if you're going to publish your paper in an academic journal, no, or a research journal. And then the last is, of course, your table of contents. You know, we will have an update of this one since you already have tables 2, 3, 4, or so many cases you have tables 3, 4, 5, no, for the results of your survey. No, katong gitabulate na ninyo. So let us start from the very beginning. Now, in your title, you just in your title page, you just kindly update. Make sure ha, you do a double check. Unsa to gi-approve nga title jud sa inyo ha, di ba kayo usab to na uban nga gipang revise sa ginagmay pag title hearing, i-apply that here. Okay, kay this will be ko ana mo na siyang i-hardbound na final defense na ganita. complete na inyong paper, i-defend na lang ninyo ang results, and then, muna na siya ang for hardbound. So, dapat ang final title na dyan ninyo ibutang, okay? And then, we'll just change a thesis presented to the senior high school faculty. Katuha, ang uban ninyo to, resem or japon, you just kaya ni-check kay mabalaan. Okay? In partial fulfillment of the requirements, not for the degree, but for the subject, there is an update na no? Inquiries and investigations, appeal na po ang koan. Nanalimot ako na, mind block ko galit. Iniwa tayo pamahaw. Practical research too. Okay, and then you change proponents to researchers. Why? Because you're not going to propose anymore. This is a final or finished paper na. So you change it to researchers. And then instead of June 2022 nakabutang. Since you will be ending in May, May ang nakabutang dira. Okay, for the approval sheet, what is this? No, before mo hardbound, I will not allow you, like let's say, mahuman na mo og kuan, no? Mahuman na mo edit sa inyo ang thesis. Kaya pag uman nyo, nakapasar mo sa final defense, na ipa-revise ginagmay sa sister, kuan na ba, sister Shera, na may mga ipang-revise ginagmay dira. Before, you will have your book bind na, let's say, inyo nang iprint ha, careful mo kung magprint mo, make sure nga walay nakabroken dira, naka-PDF siya. So, ako pa nang i-check before nyo iprint. Okay? So, right after, let's say, nag-edit na mo, you will print out one approval sheet and you will let us sign. So, I will sign this first, of course. And then, pagka man, di na mabutang grade ha, blank ra na siya. We will just see right after na sa kanya, deliberation kung sa inyong grade. And then, on May, if our oral defense will fall on May 16, then we will write May 16. Blank lang siya na siya. Ang inyo lang i-edit diri is your title and the name of the researchers in capital and bold letters. Okay? Tangtanga lang ni apprentices. Then I will just have to change, before I will send you a sample of this one, I will just need to change the names of the panelists. As well as here, no? Requirements for the subject, siya, dili siya for the degree. Okay, and then, fix na ni. No, I will just need to change a few names and then we're good to go. So, there's no need for you to edit only the title and the name of the researchers. Okay? And then, right after, and sub the acknowledgement. This is the page wherein you're going to dedicate everything to the people who have helped you along the way. No, yeah, you need to thank God first and then your research advisor. So mani siya no, ang una is si Lord. Para sa mutanan na format Lord, research advisors, of course no, my advisor before was Dr. Rizali Mibato. And then the panel of evaluators. Again, kung kinsa to ang pangalan na kung gibutang dira, Sister Shera, Sir Vispo, Sir Versol, sila lang ibutang dira. Okay, kay gayon lain ang mga panelist eh. Ibug ka ayo. So, katul lang sila kung kinsa kong ibutang sa approval sheet. More pa ibutang mo sa magpa-thank you ka dire. And then, just remove this, no? Kay naman ko yung mga benefactors sa una. Then you thank your respondents. And also, Sir Abiliar for helping you with the statistical treatment. No need to have kung ano kaning si Judy Legaspi is our grammarian man, so we don't have a grammarian, you just remove here. Then you provide, of course, no, a dedication to your parents who supported you along the way. No? And you can even include several people there who really helped you, no? Na mo-educate kayo siyang pagtabang sa paghuman sa inyong thesis. Okay? So mag-dedication na siya. Okay? Dedication to the people who've helped you finish your research paper. Then the next one is abstract. So, when say contents abstract, the abstract includes a comprehensive summary of your entire research paper starting from chapter 1 to chapter 4. So, you will start here with the first paragraph, a bit of introduction, like a very small lang introduction, like this one, like a very brief paragraph lang of an introduction about your paper. Let's say, in your introduction is about productivity online and face-to-face, diba? So you have to provide, like, you have to go back to your introduction and try to just get an excerpt, a part of there, wherein it introduces level of productivity, nag-vary between online and face-to-face, depende on sa klase sa inyong research, okay? And then, provide also, this part will be your statement of the problem. So, katong mga questions in your SOP or statement of the problem, you provide it here. Okay, here. So, direk, just a brief introduction, then your statement of the problem. To be followed by your methodology, which will be here. So, this is a compressed, like, discussion lang of your methodology from here. So, for example, descriptive research design. So, so yung design, like comparative, quantitative, iputan nyo dira. And then followed by what kind of sampling you utilize. So, if you don't have a sampling method, let's say your sampling method is, kato no, convenient sampling, o kung convenient sampling or purposive, you write that here. Then, how many respondents in the study, and then what is your survey questionnaire, researcher made ba siya, may tag checklist yes or no, answerable by yes or no, since most of you are using Likert scale, do not say, oh, the data was gathered using researcher made checklist, dili siya checklist, no, researcher made survey questionnaire, kay Likert scale man siya, no, utilize 5-4-3-2-1 or 4-3-2-1. Okay. Now, since nahuman naman mo sa inyong paper, aato ikuan ha, nahuman naman mo sa inyong paper, palihog lang, you go back to your methodology, you change some words there into past tense na. So, di ba sa una, the data will be gathered, the researcher will gather. Di ba, mo na sa una no, katong wala pa mo ka-survey. Kaya kinahuman naman mo survey, nahuman na mo og kanang collect sa inyong, or let's say tabulate sa inyong data, you have already the findings na, change those words into past tense, no? Kato yung mga adverbs, yung mga adverbs ninyo, no? So, oh, parsani, the data was gathered, past tense na, kay human naman, naka-survey naman mo. So, the data was gathered using a researcher-made checklist questionnaire. Okay, part po na siya, no? Very brief discussion of your methodology here. Okay? So, first part, like a very brief, gamay lang siya nga idea or introduction about your study followed by your statement of the problem, which is kani siya, no? Very taas man siya kay daghan mo kong intervening variables. So, sa inyo ha, sulatra po na ninyo, paragraph form. Sumpayan dayon og methodology. So, here, you know, what sampling method did you utilize followed by your respondents followed by what kind of questionnaire you utilize. And then, your statistical treatment here. So, if you're using like chi-square t-test, Pearson R, and simple percentage method, you write it here. Since ako a simple percentage method raman, so more na kong gisulat, no? Descriptive analysis. Inyuha is descriptive analysis through simple percentage and weighted mean and inferential statistics with, what is it, no? Pearson R, t-test chi-square. So, yung apply nyo, no? Ito dulo ni Sir Abeliar. And then, the next paragraph will include the findings na. So, kani yung mga katong results. Taas, no? So, mara yung ibutang. Diba, nagbutang mong summary sa tanan kung sa research analysis ninyo based on the findings. Okay. Sa research analysis ninyo, nagbutang mong summary sa tanan. Like, for example, you have data sa online face-to-face ng level of productivity, and you also have data sa academic performance, you also have data, no, or interpretation sa significant difference or significant relationship, then muna ninyo i-summarize dili tanan, i-compress lang. Okay, so muna no, discuss ninyo ang findings, inyong abstract, summarize na siya, compress katong sa chapter 3 ninyo, di ba, by table man tong explanation kani dili sa abstract, gi-compress na, gitingob tanan from table 2, 3, 4 nimo, no, katong table nimo, explanation nimo sa face-to-face, online, explanation nimo sa academic performance ba, explanation nimo sa significant relationship, no, katong hypothesis testing nimo, ng explanation, itingob nila nimo, compress nimo siya tanan diri. Okay? And then, the last paragraph is, how your study will contribute to the community. Let's say the research contributes to the gap in the literature. Since there are only few who studied mo ni siya, no, sa muang study. And then how will you use the findings of the study? So your study will be utilized in what? In a proposed intervention program ba ron? No, kung sa ABM ba na siya, a proposed marketing plan. Usually intervention program raman sa uban, di ba? Basis to design or propose an intervention program. Kumara na, no? So meaning abstract is just a compress or let's say a summary, comprehensive summary of your entire research paper starting from chapter 1, which includes a brief glimpse of your introduction, statement of the problem, then move to your methodology, very brief lang, usa ka paragraph, followed by the findings, no, results na sa inyong survey, interpretation sa inyong table, mo na siya tanan, then the last is, of course, no, chapter 4, which includes how will you utilize the findings of the study, no, which is part of the recommendations. Okay, so muna ang unod sa abstract. Nakasabot ra sa time students.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Any questions before you will proceed? None? Okay, if none, let us proceed. So the next is your table of contents. You already have this, I think, no? Nana, may table of contents, di ba? Hello? Okay, so I think you already have your table of contents. What's missing na lang is what? No, your results and discussion. This is chapter 3. So you have to update that one, no? Siguro ako lang i-edit, no? Just kindly expect an edit of this one probably. I'll try this afternoon. Pero if dili madala, siguro karong gabi eh, kay I have class tomorrow, no? Basin mabisi ko, whole day among class. Mga Sunday na siya na ako malihok or Saturday evening. But hopefully, kaya ako pa ni edit pati ang katong inyuhang para di na mo magtagbog edit pa jud ba, no? There is a confusion on niya kung mag-iya mag-edit. So I will just edit the approval sheet and I will also edit the table of contents so that diretso nila mo fill out sa mga page number. Okay? So an update of your chapter 3 and 4 na sa inyong table of contents. And please, kindly update also your list of tables. Remember, you have several tables, di ba? Not only the respondents, you already have a table na for your results na sa survey. So, palihog lang ko og butang dire. Now, again, di ay nalimot kong mention. Di ba, sa inyong paper ba, kung muagto mo sa paper na ni Alexia Pascua, di ba, naka-horizontal man to ang ilahang, or naka-landscape ang ilang table, no? So, na ay setting sana, you try to go to YouTube and search for murag ka ng step-by-step process on how to merge portrait and landscape pages. Kay kung ato par sa inyuhan, no, ang inyuhang table na kita na ko is very big, you know, pang landscape jud siya. Nya, dili man pwede nga i-separate ato ang table sa manuscript, di ba? So, pag pangita mo og kuano ka ng tutorial sa YouTube nga pwede ma-merge ang vertical or ang portrait pages which contains your paper and landscape pages which contains your table, no? Gitabulate ang results sa inyuhang survey. Kaya naka-landscape man to. Para at least mausar siya ka-document. Okay, naara na siya sa kuan. Muna ko na limot og mention last time. So, kindly update your list of tables in your table of contents. Dungag na mo sa katong inyuhang. Kung para sila ka-JV, tulo ang nadungag sila ha. So, you update, no, na 3 additional tables there. Okay, update lang po sa pages. Okay? And then, dili na malihok ang list of figures. Usara man na siya, conceptual model. Not unless if your study is qualitative and you... And it is like ground-based theory approach. So that's why you will need like a model. You have to develop a model for that. But since we are in quanti, then you will just have this one, no? Conceptual, usara ang ato ang under list of figures. Yan ka ni, mura na, no? List of tables update rata. Okay, questions sa preliminary pages. This is what contains the preliminary pages, ha? Kindly apply the borders that I gave you. This one is footer raman na sa tourism goods. So just kindly apply the border also here, except sa title page. Ayaw ninyo butay ko ano. Narin na, so, ma'am, on saan pag-apply, ma'am, nga dili ma-appeal ang title page. So, for example, kani, diba, wala na-appeal. Akong gibuhat ang sa header, under settings, or header and footer options di, different first page akong i-click. Kaya kung dili na ko siya i-click, ma-appeal og butang og footer or mabutang og border ang title page. Nya ang first page bias title page, wala siya kuan ha, dapat wala siya limpira siya, wala siya border. So butang ko different first page. Okay, para siya ang dili ma-affected sa footer or sa border ang title page, this one. Title page. Pero the rest, ang approval sheet, down to table of contents na array footer or border. Okay? Any questions before you will proceed? These are only the contents of the preliminary pages and then appendices na dayon. Kasi na, namo aning uban, no? Himuuno na lang. Questions? Wala? Okay. So, since we're what? Since may tingo, let us proceed to appendices. Okay. So what are the appendices? The appendices usually comes right after your reference list. So, di ba, ang pinakalas yung chapter is chapter 4, followed by reference list, APA format. This will be the next step, your appendices. So, diritsunday na appendix A, you provide here your research-informed consent form. Katong na ay parent consent form and child assent form, you provide it here. Okay? So, appendix B and C na to siya. So, kani, ang appendix B na ko research instrument, kay wala mong ko child assent form o parent consent form. Pero, kung inyuhang research na ay child assent form and parent consent form for those respondents above, respondents nga below 18 years old, then ang appendix B ninyo will not be research instrument anymore. Your appendix B will be your child assent form, parental consent form, and child assent form, ang appendix C. Okay? So, diri appendix B, kuha niya siya. Kung wala ka ana, kay above 18 naman imong respondents, like pareha sa ABM, no, nga ilahang respondents, kay mga dagko naman, di, ang appendix B ninyo is research instrument ditso. Katunay parental o assent form, appendix D na. No, appendix D na ang research instrument or questionnaire. And then, naman mo ani, compile na lang. And then, appendix C, no, sa katong walay assent o parental form is documentation. So, wala mo kaya documentation dyan, no? Katulang inyong mga oral defense na may mga pictures ato, no? So, pakibutang na lang. Title hearing, pre-oral. Wala, ito kakapapicture at itong nagkuan mo, no? Nag-compute-compute mo sa survey. Sige lang. So, kana lang, no? Mga virtual na ito, mga meetings. And last is, of course, your researcher profile. So, you kindly provide your educational background. Kuan lang, high school lang, no? Senior high school, or elementary. No more work experience, just your educational background. Work experience is intended for college. Okay. And then, sa 2x2 ba, nga photo, if mahimo, leaders, kindly inform your members to take a picture of themselves in a white background. Nagay di mag-white background, ako dyan ang tangtangon school logo, dyan akong imbutang sa inyong researcher profile. Para uniform tatanan, white background, naka-school uniform, girls will need to fix their hair. 2x2 hay nga ni ra bust ra dili ho pag 2x2 gani nya mag full body na na jud ko 100 ani ha 2x2 bust ra ha persa ni ba nya lami tani no kung inyo hang graduation di ba i-release good so dili lang sa to dili lang sa to kuan lang naka school uni mo boys will have proper haircut, girls kuan naka-fix ilahang hair, white background, 2x2 ha, ing ani. Di na mapapicture sa studio, kat na lang pwede ra sa balay basta hayag po, dili kay kanang ngit-ngit pug kaayo nga di makita imong naong, no kana pong hayag pud nga kuan ba, nga picture nga dili pud taon ngit-ngit pud, no? And then kuan, comment ha. Basta dili gani mag-follow sa instructions, I will remove the photo and I will change it with the school logo. Ha, para uniform, limpyo tatanan. Okay. Again, white background. Bust lang, no? 2x2. Naka-school uniform. Girls must need to fix their hair. Boys, proper haircut. So, kanara, very simple lang na kuan. Anyway, that's the last part. Why do we need this? So that, you know, at least the people who will read your paper will have an idea who the researchers are. Okay? Then that's it, no? Researcher profile. Mura na unod, no? Very simple, rajud kaayo. Again, leaders, you can disseminate this task to other members. Kay, this is really, really quite easy to do, no? Dili lang yung ikaw mo shoulder anitanan. Let them compile what is in the appendices. And again, once you already have this, isumpay sa inyong full paper, kuyog dito, sa pinakalas ni siya, kuyog chapter 1 and 2 ni mo, sumpay ni siya dito sa 1. Sa imuhang reference list, okay? This comes after the reference list. Okay? So, those are the contents of the appendices. Very simple. Some of this, naana mo, gagmay lang ang buhat, ano? Ang documentation lang, butang ag caption, and also the researcher's profile. Let other members do this, okay? As you work, ani ha? As you work on your double time, tano? As you work on your chapter 3 and 4, ang uban nga walay gibuhat, pabuhata aning ipakumpile aning appendices og preliminary pages. Okay, pakumpila sila ana. If feel niyo nga dili niyo bet sila pasulaton sa abstract og kuan, let them write so that they will know. Okay? Nya ikaw kun di ka kauyon pwede man nimo i-revise. You have the Grammarly for that to correct your grammar. But again, still do proofreading pud on your part because there are times that Grammarly is not so perfect. Many times nga they cannot correct properly the kuan pud, no? So where technology ends, human intelligence continues, no? So muna siya. Okay, so mura jud ni, no? Mura ni preliminaries and appendices. Mahuman na jud mo 3 and 4, sulat mo ani, pero pwede ra jud as you work for 3 and 4 until next week, also do this, no? Disseminate para dali mahuman. If you can pass by May 11, we can immediately submit your manuscript to the panelist. We'll upload that in our Google Drive link. Okay? A Google Drive folder. And again, ha, paging. No? Ang butang ako, naka-page number ba ta? Basta kadumdum na mo ato, no? I don't know if sa tourism na ko ni natudlo. Basta preliminary pages, numeral, lowercase numeral, numbers, kung body na yun siya, appeal ani, no? Appeal sa appendices, Arabic na. Okay? And then, tabunan ra to ang every chapter page. Same goes with the title page, tabunan na siya, like so. What we did here, ah, di siya makita. Okay, different page number. Up, different first page. Okay, so more na. Questions. Mga pangutana. We are done. May mura rin yung dungan sa 3 and 4. Basta ma-disseminate ragtarong sa inyong mga kauban. Questions? Everyone? I think it was clear naman siguro for some. Okay na?
Yeah.
Yes, Reed.
Kung sa yung deadline sa tanandam.
If you can make it 11, I would appreciate it. But the very conjuna, ang pinaka dugay na jud na akong ihatag nga deadline, do not force yourself again, no? If dili makaya, if mabana-bana ninyo nga di jud makaya by 11, okay jud sa 13 or 14. Okay? Dapat before 16 kompleto na jud na tanan. Kay 16 man ta mag-oral defense. We will have that by 16 because we cannot have it later than that because you still have your kuan pa no mga practice pa sa graduation. Ang ako ang hangyo sa clearance. When is your clearance signing, by the way? Were you already given clearances na? When were you let your kuan sign your clearance? Does anybody have an idea? Wala pa may balita kano sa inyong clearance signing? STEM students? Princess, wala sila ikuan? Hello? Am I audible, everyone?
Wala pa ganoon si Madam Mio daw.
Ay, okay. Because if that's the case, let's say if they will have clearance signing by next week, siguro kung di mo kaabot sa tunay butang ha, kung dili man mo makaabot man di ay Japon sa deadline sa clearance, let's say before 13 ang deadline sa clearance, then musay na Japon ko ana, but please make sure to submit it by 13. Pero if next week Friday pa ang deadline, then motion akong requirement sa clearance ang inyong full paper. Okay? Kaya kung masking clearance or not, kabalo man jud kung mo-submit man mo. Kaya importante na jud na siya nga malihok na to. Your deliberation will be on the 10th, no? Dili na nato ma-include ang sa kaning inyong hangkuan. But I am keeping track of your performances. Now, I would like to ask the leaders to kindly provide me with a rating. Karun ha, kay, since you are writing 3 and 4, of your members based on their participation. Kaya include na ko na sa paggrado sa inyo ha. I already have the individual grading sheets, grading or evaluation sheets from pre-oral. Mapun na ko ang basihan. Okay? So, sa final, delete yung kakuan. The best thing that we can pick out, I don't know if they allow us to pick best paper, but we will deliberate from your performance sa pre-oral o recently lang karun nga naghimo mo 3 and 4, kinsa jud ang maayo, no? 4. And we do hope that the deliberation will still be moved by kuan, by 13. Pending pa na ang 16 ha, kay muda ko nun na siyang announcement of honors. If dili gani, we can just have it by 18. We cannot have it by 17. I have an oral defense sa college, Anna. So please, no, by 13, if pwede mahimo na, makompleto siya. Kung makaya pa rin yung 11, the better. Okay? Para sayo-sayo na. Kaya mas tindot makuha na mo sa 11. Kaya ma-insert pa na mo na sa deliberation last minute. Kaya di man na, totally mahuman na mo by 10. Following day pa na mo mahuman po sa 11. So that na-include pa rin na mo na we will... We will read your paper pa. Okay? Kung madala sa 11 ha, sa 13 ang pinakadugay. Pinakadugay na jud. Labi na concerning ilakagarabato. Wala pa sila ka-finalize jud, no? Kailang academic performance pa. Is garabato around? Wala, no? But, if nadiri ang kagrupo ni garabato ba, palihog lang jud ta, mas maayo makakuha na siya sa iyahang o ano mga grades karon nga si Mana kay para ugma maka-meet na siya ni Sir Abelier. Mas ni makalangay. Anyway, sa pamanlain na to nga i-discuss, I think that's it, Raman. Again ha, 11 if madala, 13 kung pinakadugay na jud. Di na ta pwede mo lapas kay 16 or 18 dira ta mag oral defense. Okay, so some more questions. Wala na. Okay, so I think wala na may questions ang tanan. If you have additional questions, you can just message me later. Okay? And then I'll just upload the recording this afternoon. Then try to edit pa, no, kay, we have a meeting manggood karon po sa institutional regarding graduation and other preparations pa. Okay? So since wala na may mga additional questions, let us end our session quite early, no? 35 minutes ra, wala naman tayo laing dugayan. So let us end our session for this morning with a prayer. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory be to the Father and to the